Hello everybody, welcome back to a new video. This one is book haul. I have quite a few books to show you. I acquired all these since I came back to Scotland in mid-January and I have a few, these, and some behind me in the book haul. Somehow my brain thought it's locked down. We want to support small bookshop and small publishers, but we also want to buy books that are on sale. So, do I think there's a healthy amount of books to get? No, but am I still excited to read them? Yeah, so no shame here, just no shame. I'm not going to present these in any particular order, I'm just going to present them as I go. Also, I'm not going to give any synopsis because we're going to be here for a very long time otherwise. So excuse me if I don't give any synopsis. Goodreads is your friend. So the first book I got is Last Night at the Telegraph Club. I got this one as category is books, which is a queer independent bookshop in Glasgow. I ordered on their website and it arrived so quickly. I think it took 3 days for it to arrive. Very impressed. And all I know about this book is that it's queer and it's Asian, and it made my heart very happy to know this. It also takes place in 1954, which is not like the best, just the best era to be Asian and queer. A few of my friends have already read it and they all enjoyed it immensely, so I'm excited. Next I have The House in the Studency, which is one of my favorite books of last year. I adore this book. It's so pure. It will make you happy and make you cry a little bit, but not of sadness, mostly of happiness. So if you haven't read it yet, please pick it up. I gave my copy of Hide and Front to a friend and I really wanted one for here just so I can reread it, which will happen very soon. And I'm excited, and also it's such a pretty cover. I'm in love. Then we have a book I got because it was pretty cheap on Waterstones because there was a sale, and that's Home Stretch. This book kind of gave me normal people vibe, and it also reminded me of one of my favorite books that's written in French, which is Réparer les Vivants. I think this book is going to destroy me and make me cry, and I'm fine with it. I have been looking at it for a few weeks. Like, when we were still able to go into bookshops, I had looked at it time and time again, so I'm happy I finally have it. Still with the Waterstones book sale, I got Memorial. I love this cover, it's so pretty. Just Google this book, look at the US cover and tell me that the UK one isn't the prettiest, because this is an absolute beauty. I don't make the rules. I just know that it's queer and that's enough for me. I also think one of the characters is Asian. Yeah, I think that's going to be amazing, so I'm pretty excited. You know what, I'm going to show you the last book I got this Waterstones sale. This way it will be out of the way. So I got Hamnet. Everybody and their mom has been talking about this book, so I thought it was time for me to get it during this sale. It's the Waterstones exclusive edition. It's gorgeous. Just look at it. It's very pretty. Even on the inside it's pretty, so I just know this has something to do with Shakespeare somehow. And that's it. That's basically it. I've just realized there is a rabbit here and an owl here. That's very cute. That's very, very cute. I like it. Next in front of me, I have Eyes Like Kiss in the Corners. I've already read it. It's so precious. It's an easy 5 out of 5 stars. I saw this book at my local bookshop, like right in my street. I was walking in front of it and I saw it in the windows and I was like, I need it. I've been trying to find this book everywhere and you're telling me that you have it here. So I went back to the bookshop when it was open. I knocked on the door and the manager was like, can I help you? And I basically told her all my life that I had been looking for this book for a very long time and I was able to buy it at the door, and I'm very happy about it. The illustrator is Vietnamese and this makes me so happy. So yeah, it was just pure adorable. The art style is gorgeous. absolutely gorgeous. I love it. So if you haven't got your hands on it yet, please do. Then we have a gift from my dad, and that's Uprooted and Spinning Silver. So that's the Illumicrit special edition that comes in a box set. Why is it so hard every single time to get the books out of this? So first we have Uprooted, which is absolutely gorgeous. Oof. And then we have Spinning Silver, once again, gorgeous. And I wanted these books because I read A Daily Education recently and really liked it. I really liked Naomi Novik's writing style, so just wanted to read more by her. And I saw that Illumicrit had these beautiful editions, and my dad said, okay, I'm getting them for you for Hanukkah, so here you go. And we got them sent here in Scotland, so I wouldn't have to bring them back in my suitcase, so here they are. And the box set is very pretty, honestly. Next is Negative Capability. So that's a memoir slash nonfiction. It's published by Simpson Press, which is a independent publisher in Scotland. And I follow them on Instagram. And the way they describe this book just made me want to buy it. It's basically about surviving when everything around you is shit. And that resonated a lot with me because my mental health hasn't been the best lately. So I thought, why not give it a try? And I'm 15 pages in. I've just haven't been able to read much lately, so I'm hoping to get to this month, fingers crossed. And it's also a gift from my dad. Next is a book that I had been highly anticipating. I was so jealous when everybody got it, thanks to Book of the Month. They got it like very early, I think 3 months early, and that's This Close to Okay. First of all, this cover is absolutely incredible. I love it. Orange makes me very happy. It's my favorite color, so this, yes, please. All I know about this book is that it deals with mental health, and that's something I very much like to read about because usually it makes me cry a lot, and I'm all for a very cathartic reading experience. Yeah. But I've only seen good things about this book, which makes me very excited. Also, this guy looks so pretty. Look at the freckles. Then I have another book that I got on Waterstones, but it was more than half price. So I got it because I've been wanting to read this book for so long, and that's Shaggy Bane. So this book is one of the two Scottish books that won the Booker Prize. I think the last one was in the 90s. Many of my friends have read this book. Many of my friends have loved this book. I think it's about industrial Scotland during the Thatcher era. So, pretty hard subject to read about. Also mental health and being queer. So, am I excited? Fuck yes, I think this book is going to be 5 stars. Just like this book, I have a feeling that this book is also going to be 5 stars, so fingers crossed. Then we have 2 books that I got at the same time, and they go together. I got them from a small independent publisher in Scotland, which is called Monstrous Regiment, and that's the Bible and the Bible New Testimonials. So these are 2 anthologies of essays about being bisexual in the UK. It's so hard to find books, non-fiction books about being bisexual, so when I saw these, I grabbed them. Also, they just scream my aesthetic, so pretty happy. Pretty, pretty happy. Next, we have a book that was sent to me by the publicist at Cornerstone, and that's The Intoxicating Mr. Lavelle. Basically, the publicist sold this book to me by saying it was queer and historical with little Bridgerton twist. I was like, okay, please give me this book. So I'm excited to read it. It's a very pretty cover. I'm very much vibing with this cover. The bright pink. Yes, please. Also, I really love the little heart on the cheek. It's very nice. Next is a book that I've already read. So that's The House at the Edge of Magic, which is kind of the middle grade version of The House of Mystery and Sea. A little bit. A tiny bit. It was so pure. I read it in one sitting, very much enjoyed it, and then at the end I discovered that it's the first book in a middle grade series, and I was like, yes, we are winning today. To me, the main element of this book is found family, and we all know how much I fucking adore this trope. So if you want a little book about found family, here you go. Also, it's so cute. I'm excited. I'm so excited to read the second book. Unfortunately, I think it comes out next year because this book was released at the beginning of the year. But it's fine. It's fine. I will live. Next is also a book that I've already read, and that's Written in the Stars, which is a queer retelling of Pride and Prejudice. I found this book to be extremely adorable. It was fun, it was cute, it was fast-paced. It made me very happy. I was reading it whilst I was in self-isolation when I came back to Scotland. I was not in the best mood, but this book just made me happy. So we need more sapphic books in our lives, I think, in my humble opinion, you know. Next, we have a book that was kindly sent to me by Valerie UK, and that's A Knock of My List. So the title is here, and here it says, Once Upon a Time, There Was a Villain. So they are also sending me a finished copy that's supposed to get to me in the next few days. Fingers crossed. I'm part of a blog tour, so you can go on my Instagram and my Twitter to see what I think of this book. But basically, it's a Sleeping Beauty retelling, and make it sapphic as well. We love all the sapphic retelling, like, we are winning. And also, in this one, Aura falls in love with the Wicked Witch. I think we can all admit that we sapphic people are winning this year. You know what, let's continue with the sapphic content, because we have Honey Girl, which is one of my favorite books of the year. I loved this book so much. It's one of those books I think is going to be extremely relatable to younger millennials, older Gen Zs. It deals a lot with being lost and not knowing what to do with your life, but also trying to find yourself and falling in love for the first time. As I said, it's sapphic and it's fucking adorable. This book will make you cry and laugh at the same time. And that's just a perfect combination, I think. So, if you haven't read Honey Girl yet, what are you doing with your life? Like, there is a reason why everybody's giving this book 5 stars. Because it's fucking good. I mean, I made my flatmate read it, and she loved it as well, so... Not to say that I have taste, but I have taste when it comes to sapphic books. Next we have The Boy, the Mole, the Fox, and the Horse, which I've also read. It's just a wholesome book. I think it's a book that you should read when you're not feeling well, because it's going to make you feel seen and make you feel as if someone is hugging you and wrapping you in a huge blanket. It's just very pure, very adorable. The art style is gorgeous. Wait. I just love it. It's very quick to read. I think I read it in 30 minutes, 45 minutes, can't remember, but it was very fast. And you just spend a really good time with this little boy and his friends. And yeah, it's just about friendship and love, and it's very pure. Next we have a book that I already own back in France, but I was feeling like rereading it, and I think I have 40 pages left, so I'm going to finish that after I'm done filming this video. But that's Little Women. The 2020 movie is one of my favorite movies. I watch it all the time. And I had read the first part of the book, so Little Women, but I'd never read Good Wives, the second part. And that's a shame, because it's my favorite part in the movie, and it's also my favorite part in the book. Like, I have this left. It's not much, and I'm excited to finish it, even though I already know how it ends. But it's just such a pure book. It's an easy 5 stars. I already know it, so if you haven't read Little Women yet, do yourself the favor. I know it's not the book with the most action at the beginning, but it's mostly character driven, and it's just a pure book, you know. It's not about action, it's just about reading about these four sisters and their family and their lives. Next we have a book I've already read but haven't yet. What am I singing? I don't know. It's Chain of Iron. So that's the edition you could have if you participated to Cassie's UK tour, I think. And basically it's just the jacket that's different, and underneath it's the usual book, but the jacket is gorgeous. I'm assuming this is Cordelia and this is James. But yeah, I haven't read this book yet. I don't know why. I'm scared of having my heart destroyed, but also I'm scared of being spoiled, because I've already spoiled a bit about the book, and I don't want to be spoiled even more. So I'm going to read this book in April. Finally, it's probably my favorite series in the Shadowhunter world, even though my favorite character is Mark Blackthorne, so Lady Midnight and all the books like that. But yeah, I love these kids so much, and my favorite character in this series, either Thomas or Alistair, although I love James, but Thomas, I love him. I would give my love for him. So excited. Next we have a trilogy, which is the Chaos Walking trilogy, which is one of my favorite trilogies ever, and I just didn't own copies, so I wanted the black edition so badly, even though this is supposed to be black and it's not black, and I'm sad. But anyway, yeah, so we have The Knife of Never Letting Go, The Ask and the Answer, and Monsters of Men. So if you haven't read this trilogy, what the fuck are you doing? I just love it with my entire heart. It's very peculiar, but it's definitely worth it. Like, even if you think the first book is fucking weird, please keep going, because it just gets better and better. And Patrick Ness is a talented author. He's incredible. I love all his books. The next stack of books is books I was sent by the publishing company I'm interning for, because I'm going to be creating content for their Instagram. So I was able to give a little list of books I wanted, and I got them. Although the first book I'm going to show you is one I got myself, but it's still from Clutching Press. So the first one is Happiness is Wasted on Me. All these books have something to do with Scotland, just going to say it. So this book is taking place in Cumbernauld, which is a little town in Scotland, and the main characters are sexual. It says it at the back, and the author is really nice, and I've already started reading it. I'm on page 48. It's also a book I'm hoping to finish in April, but the writing style is very engaging. It's different, but very engaging. So I'm excited to keep on reading it. And the next six books have been sent to me by Fledging Books. So the first one is a memoir called Start. Can you see it? Come on, focus on it. Yeah, okay. So this one is a memoir about living with schizophrenia, and it's divided by a month. I think it takes place throughout an entire year, and I requested it because we're going to publish the second memoir of this author this year, so I wanted to be able to read this one first and then promote it on our Instagram. By the way, I will leave the Instagram in the description, because I'm going to start posting content tomorrow, so that's always exciting. Next is The Calling. So all I know about this book is it's what if all the statues in Edinburgh came to life. Sounds very interesting. I'm very, very intrigued. Also, this little dog is so cute. I've walked in front of him many, many times. Basically, if you rub his nose, you will have luck. So, cute. Next is a book I've already read, and that's Wollagig. It's a crime slash mystery novel. I read it in 2 days. Not even 2 days. I read it so quickly, so engaging, so engrossing. The writing style is pretty amazing, honestly. I read it just before my interview for my internship, because I wanted to be able to say that I'd read a book from them, and I'm so glad I read this one. It was so interesting, and the second book is coming out this year. I'm so excited for it. I can't recommend this one enough. It takes place in the Highlands. People start dying in very fucking weird way, and it's so interesting. Next is a book my manager described as gothic and feminist, and that's Ghost. That's basically all I know about it. Am I exciting to read it? Yes, Yes, very much. Very fucking much. And it's so floppy. Also, there is mud on the pages of most of these books because I took them outside to take pictures and one of my friends gave me a tomato plant and there was mud on it, but I still put it in my bag. And now there is a little bit of mud on all the pages. It's fine, they've lived. Next on the list is For My Sins, which is all about Mary Stuart. Do I need to say more? Mary Stuart? Also, all the books I requested, either we have a book by this author coming this year or the author wrote several books with us, so I just wanted to be able to promote them on our Instagram, but also took the ones I was the most interested in because I'm going to read them. So, and finally, I have Ways of the Doomed, which is the first book in a trilogy, and I love this cover. It takes place in a futuristic Scotland. That's all I know, and that intrigues me a lot. Yeah, we're going to talk about some of these books, so let's bring them a little bit closer. So, we're nearly done, I promise. So many books! Okay, the first I have is How We Are Translated. It takes place in Scotland. The main character, wow, is Swedish and Brazilian. Yeah, no, she's Swedish. Her boyfriend is Brazilian, born and Scottish. Honestly, I just really love the cover. And it was a signed edition that was available at one of my favorite independent bookshops, so I just decided to get it. Next, I got a book that I was so excited to finally get. It's Rent a Boyfriend. I love Gloria Chow. She wrote one of my favorite books, which is American Panda. I love it so much, and I've been anticipating this book since it was announced, I think 2017, something like that. I don't really know, I just know it's about fake dating, which is one of my favorite tropes, and the cover is absolutely adorable. Also, it came ripped just here, so I had to be washed deep. I was not happy, but it's fine. So yeah, excited to read this one very, very soon. I say very, very soon, but if you see any Asian books here that I haven't read yet, I'm probably keeping them for next month. If you know why I'm keeping them for May, tell me in the comments. Let's see. Who knows? Next is also an Asian book, and that's A Taste for Love. There is boba on this cover. Yes, please. Basically, I got a lot of Asian books because I was sad, and whenever I'm sad, I'm like, just need to buy more Asian books, you know? It's fine with me. I don't mind spending my money on Asian authors, so. Next, we have a book that I had been anticipating, but I wasn't planning on getting now. But I watched a Zoom with the author of this book and the author of Malice, and I just need this book in my life right now, and that's The Shadow in the Glass, which is a Cinderella retelling taking place in the Victorian era, and it's gothic. These sold the book to me. I was like, okay, it's more really great. Okay, let's go buy the book. So I pre-ordered it. I love my life. Next is a book I got just because my friend Anna couldn't stop talking about this book and this series, so I was like, I'm just going to get it and read it because it sounds exciting, and that's The Iron King. You've probably all already read this book, and I'm very late to the party, but it's fine. I don't mind being late to the party because it means I was able to get this very pretty cover, which I think is for the 10th anniversary, something like that, and they redid all the series. Anyway, do I know what this book is about? No, like, no fucking clue. I just really trusted Anna. So, see? You can see all the covers they redid. I'm excited. It's been a while since I've read a really good fantasy book. So, yeah, I'm excited. Obviously, if I get a book, it's because I'm excited to read it. So, shut up for me. Oh, I forgot to say that The Iron King was also a gift from my dad. It's part of the books I got for when I moved in, and the next one is also one of them. I got Writers and Lovers I've been hearing a lot of incredible things about this book. I really love the cover they did for the US paperback, but when I said that the UK paperback would be getting this cover, my heart just knew I would have to get this specific edition, because this is simply glorious. Also, this gives me Normal People vibes. I have to stop saying that, but it's giving me Normal People vibes. But Normal People is one of my favorite books, and if I can read more books that are like this, I will. So excited, you guessed it. I have 4 books left. We can do it, fam. We can do it. Next is also an app that was sent to me by Delray UK, and that's The Wolf and the Woodsman. How to tell you how excited I am about this book. It comes out in June, and it's inspired by Jewish mythology and Hungarian history. If you say that a book is inspired by Jewish mythology, I'll just say yes, please, give it to me. Thank you. Yeah, also this arc is so pretty. I've seen the cover, I really like it, but I think they did an incredible job with this arc. Like, this foil, it's glorious. I'm excited to read it. I've just realized that if I don't read it this month, I won't be able to read it in May, because I'm only reading Asian books in May. And this comes out in June, so the 8th of June. So that's just been put on my TBR. Next is also a book I got at Toppings and Company, which is one of my favorite bookshops, which is also the bookshop I got We Are Translated. So yeah, I got Hood Feminism based on what everybody is saying. I know I have to read it, and I just know that I can't call myself an intersectional feminist if I'm not aware of everything that's going on. So I will be reading this very soon. So the last two books were part of my I need to buy Asian books because I'm feeling sad, okay? I have a weird way to cope with sadness and anxiety. The next book is York. Look at this beauty. Yes. Oh, it's amazing. Like, the hands continue on the edges. It's very pretty. I really like Marriage Ke Choi. I've read both of her books. Emerging Adult is one of my favorite books. Permanent Record, I'm a bit divided on it because I really enjoyed the first 25% and loved the last 25%, but I was a bit disappointed with the middle of the book. But I still think Marriage Ke Choi has a lot of important things to say. So I got this book. I don't think I will be reading this one soon. Not as soon as the other ones. I will see. It depends on how I will feel, because this book deals with eating disorders and mine is not good at the moment. So I don't want to be too triggered when I read this book. So yeah, we'll see how I feel in May. But I'm still excited to read it, honestly. And the last book of this very, very long list is A Fall Love Story. This is a 5-star prediction. Whenever I'm able to read a book written by a Vietnamese author, I just feel like I'm being hugged, you know? Also, pho is my favorite comfort food, so I'm not going to cry, I swear, it's fine, everything's fine. And I know I'm going to love this book, and one of the main characters has my name, which makes me very happy, so I'm just going to leave it here. Okay, if you want to make me happy, just have a cocktail with my name and I'll be fine. Okay, so these are all the books I got, which is a fuck ton of books. If you read any of these, please tell me in the comments and let me know what were your thoughts about these books, and wish me good luck, because I haven't been reading a lot lately, but I still want to read all of these. Okay, so that's going to be it for this video. Thank you very much for watching it. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. That would make me very happy. And if you're not subscribed yet, maybe you can of course only if you want, and if you want to be notified for whenever I post a new video, click on the little bell. But I hope you all have an amazing rest of your day. Please remember that you're loved, and I will see you in another video. Bye.